Hello everybody and welcome to another video. This one's coming a bit late in the day, but I have been absolutely mad busy the last 2 days, which is why there was no video yesterday. I was busy running people all over the place in the car. But anyway, today we're going to be revisiting a band I've only checked out once before called Twiztid. I did a track of theirs a little while ago called Breakdown, I think it was. I had heard them slightly beforehand because they appeared in a song I did of, I think it was Tech Nine. They appeared on one of his tracks. I can't remember if it was his or not. Can't remember. But anyway, this is a song I had suggested a while back, and it is a track called Kill Somebody. Now, with this being Twiztid, I'm not expecting it to have a real deep meaning to it, or, you know, anything too profound, considering, you know, Insane Clown Posse aren't exactly the deepest subject. Hip-hop itself isn't exactly known for its really deep stories. Some hip-hop songs do, but not necessarily all of them, so we'll see where it goes. I've got the lyrics up here anyway, and yeah, let's just go straight into it, I think. So it's Kill Somebody by Twiztid. Let's have a shuffle.
Shut a chop him, maybe shoot him, kill him all. Use an axe, oh my God, a knife, a chainsaw. I'm gonna kill somebody. I wanna fucking kill somebody. Shut a chop, hang a cut him, maybe shoot him, kill him all. Use an axe, or a gun, a knife, a chainsaw.
They never found anyone I used to play with, but they're all afraid to go and make a statement. Cause I'll sneak up in the basement of your place when no one's home until I'm first of many faces. Them children fucking know. And I might go into your neighbors and dress up all in their clothes when I destroy you and your family. It's really uncomfortable. I know. You're thinking it's a mistake. You're thinking that there's no reason and you've never seen my face. You're right. 100% I won't lie. There's no reason other than you have a house I wanted to try. So believing in something deep is a waste of our time. Now I'm with the crime. I don't know why. Every time I open my eyes, I just wanna kill somebody. I wanna kill somebody. Kill somebody. I wanna kill, kill, kill.
I don't know where. I'm a bugger. Why should I care? I just wanna kill somebody. Kill somebody. Kill somebody. I wanna kill, kill, kill.
Well, this is a normal sort of fare that you sort of come to expect from bands like Twiztid and ICP. And at one point, ICP and Twiztid were quite closely involved together, as far as I'm aware. But in actually reading these lyrics, some of it actually reminds me of a serial killer a little while back, but I cannot for the life of me think who it was. But I'll explain that when I come to it. It's pretty much standard fare for the most part. I mean, I like the way the song opened because they came in with, should I chop them, time to cut them, maybe shoot them, kill them all, use an axe or a gun, a knife or a chainsaw, I'm going to kill somebody, I want to kill somebody. Should I chop them, time to cut them, maybe shoot them, kill them all, use an axe or a gun, a knife, a chainsaw. Now, during that part, there wasn't any actual music, as far as I could tell. They were using sound effects for, like, guns, axes, and stuff like that to sort of create the beat of the music, and I quite liked that. I thought it was really quite clever. And that sort of thing has continued through the track so far, but they have added, like a digital drum beat and other musical sounds to the track. Then came the hook, which is when the beat dropped, as it were. He says, I don't know why, every time I open my eyes, I just want to kill somebody. I want to kill somebody, kill somebody, I want to kill. I don't know where, how the f*** or why should I care, I just want to kill somebody, kill somebody, kill somebody, I want to kill. And then came in the first verse with Monoxide, saying, I can't explain it, because most of the time I was so faded. I was surprised either one of us made it. I've been walking on the edge for so long the lines faded. Murder Go Round, well, I've played it, and Murder Go Round was actually a track by ICP on the Ringmaster album, I believe. They never found anyone I used to play with, so that sounds like a serial killer and all the dead bodies that he's played with before, you know, no one's found them yet. But they're all afraid to go and make a statement. Because I sneak off in the basement in your place when no one's home and kill the first of many faces until he f***ing knows. And I like going to your neighbours and dress up in all their clothes. When I destroy you and your family, it's really uncomfortable. I know, you're thinking it's a mistake. You're thinking that there's no reason and you've never seen my face. You're right, 100% I'm all right. There's no reason other than you have a house I wanted to try. So believing in something deep is a waste of our time. Now on with the crime. Now it's that little last bit that reminds me of a serial killer. Because I'm pretty sure there was a serial killer a little while ago. Who was going around and he would break into houses and he would kill the entire family. And then he would stay in that family's house for like several hours, maybe even a couple of days after killing them, because he wanted to live their life. He wanted to live in their house. I can't for the life of me remember who it is. So it's actually a little bit of a familiar thing. And there's like, I like going into your neighbors and dressing up in all their clothes. So it's like, again, this guy trying to have a taste of that family, you know, trying to live that family's life. I can't for the life of me think about who it was, but I'm sure I've heard something very similar to this before. Anyway, after that it went back into the hook. I don't know why, every time I open my eyes, I just want to kill somebody, I want to kill somebody, kill somebody, I want to kill. And then they change up the second half of it a very little bit. It says, I don't know where, motherfucker, why should I care? I want to kill somebody, kill somebody, I want to kill. So, a very slight change in there. But yeah, like I said, it's not exactly the deepest of songs, but it does seem to have a little bit of an actual real life story sitting in there. So, interesting. Let's carry on.
They refer to the news as a freak at night. Mirror on cloud white and a butcher knife. He escaped last night killing who he likes. He picks his victims and hits them and picks them up and then loads her unconscious body discreetly inside a truck. Save of the flavor, it'd probably be better to kill him right there. When nobody's looking, you stab him repeatedly, get it over with and nobody cares. But I'm an old-fashioned guy, gotta get the teeth and put them eyes. Cut off the hands and watch them die. Look him in the eye and say goodbye. It must be something wrong with me. I haven't slept in weeks. I'm eating blood, drinking coffee. Back up off me and fuck sleep. Fuck a sheep, I kill him too. Wear him like a nanny goat. Lunatic, what you know? Now somebody got the D.I.E. I'm K.I.L.L.I.N.G. Everyone in here for I.F.U.C.K. I am leaves. It's so crazy, I believe a thousand deaths alive in me. They all let go every time I breathe. Then it whisper at night, murder for me.
I don't know why, every time I open my eyes, I just wanna kill somebody. I wanna
maybe shoot him,
kill him all.
Use an axe,
or a gun,
a knife,
or a chainsaw.
I'm gonna kill somebody.
I wanna fucking kill somebody.
Should I chop, kinda cut him, hit
Well, there you go. Now Let's Kill Somebody by Twiztid. I actually quite enjoyed the song. I thought it was quite an enjoyable track. I mean, as we all know, I do like the occasional bit of hip-hop. I have a very vast taste in musical genres, and I quite enjoyed that. Now, when Jamie Madrox came in with that second verse there, it was sung/spoken, rapped, whatever, a lot faster than the first verse. And you've got some slightly more complex lines in there. But the description of this person's crimes has changed now in this. So whether or not this is actually based on a real person, I really don't know. But it's still quite interesting. It says, can I get an APB on a maniac, which is an all points bulletin for anybody who doesn't know, referred to on the news as a freak of night, Maron Clown White with a butcher knife. He escaped last night, killing who he likes. He picks his victim and hits him, then picks him up, and then loads their unconscious body discreetly inside the trunk. Savour the flavour, it'll probably be better to kill them right there. When nobody's looking, you're stabbing repeatedly, get it all over with, and nobody cares. But I'm an old-fashioned guy, I gotta get them teeth and both them eyes, cut off the hands and watch them die. Look them in the eye and say goodbye. There must be something wrong with me, I haven't slept in weeks, I'm eating blood, drinking coffee. Back up off me and sleep. Counting sheep, a sheep, I'll kill them too. Wear them like a nanny goat, lunatic, thought you knew. Now somebody got to D-I-E, I'm K-I-L-L-I-N-G, everybody in here for I-F-U-C-K-I-N leave. Schizo crazy, I believe 1,000 deaths alive in me. They all let go every time I breathe, then they whisper at night, murder for me. So, you know, the description of these murderous acts has changed slightly, so whether he's talking about a different person or it's the same person and he's changed up his MO, I don't know. You know, he's talking about, you know, knocking someone out, stuffing them in the trunk of his car, driving off and murdering them, you know, cutting out the eyes, knocking out their teeth, you know, which is forensically quite clever. You know, saying cutting off their hands and watching them die. And then he says, look them in the eye and say goodbye, which doesn't make sense because he's just cut out their eyes. So, you know, he's going on, you know I'm crazy, I know I'm schizo, I know I'm absolutely lost the plot, you know. I'm sitting here, you know, absolutely mad out of my skull, I know it, basically. And then it goes into that main hook again. I don't know why every time I open my eyes I just want to kill somebody, I want to kill somebody, kill somebody, I want to kill, kill, kill. I don't know where, how the... or why should I care? I want to kill somebody, kill somebody, kill somebody, I want to kill, kill, kill. And then it went to the outro, which is pretty much the same as the intro, you know, the music sort of went out, but then the rhythm to the song was done with different sort of weapons and stuff like that. Should I chop them? Time to cut them. Maybe shoot them, kill them all, use an axe or a gun, a knife or a chainsaw, I'm going to kill somebody, I want to kill somebody. Should I chop them? Time to cut them. Maybe shoot them, kill them all. Use an axe or a gun, a knife, a chainsaw. I'm going to kill somebody. I want to kill somebody. And then it went back into that hook again. I don't know why every time I open my eyes I want to kill somebody, etc. So, you know, it was a pretty catchy song. A little bit repetitive, but it was pretty catchy. And like I said, this sort of song, not necessarily a very deep, meaningful song, but it was an entertaining, catchy piece of music. And the actual video to it was really cool. The actual makeup they had was so detailed and very intricate. It was a very interesting video to watch as well. So, yes, I quite liked that. This was quite enjoyable. But I can't really say much else about it. So I'll leave that as it is. Yeah, if anybody would like to suggest a track for me to react to, then please do so. By all means, you can drop a comment in the comment section below, or you can drop me a message on my Facebook or my Instagram, or even on my Patreon, should you ever feel the want or need to help support me so I can make more of these videos, possibly even better versions. But do know, if you do make a suggestion, it will take me a while to get around to it, because, you know, I get suggested so many tracks every single day that you know, I can't keep up. For every one video I do, I get suggested at least 12 more. So, you know, I do write down every single suggestion I get, so it will get done eventually. It's just going to take me a while to get to it. Also, Metalhead Reacts is a proud supporter of the Sophie Lancaster Foundation, a British-based charity whose main focus is to put an end to hate crimes, mainly those that are aimed at the alternative subculture, people who dress in alternative fashion and listen to alternative music. Now, this is a charity that I think is very important. It's very important to me, and I think it definitely needs more attention brought to it, because, you know, every day, all over the world, we hear about various hate crimes like racism, sexism, homophobia, all that sort of thing, ableism. You know, we hear about this all the time. But what we're not hearing enough about is these people that are getting violently attacked just because of the music that they listen to. You know, the people who are wearing alternative fashion and, like, listening to alternative music are getting violently, violently beaten just because of the way that they dress and the music that they listen to. And it is ridiculous. And it happens every day, all over the world. And it just goes unmentioned. But it is a serious problem. You know, people are getting hospitalized just because of, you know, their personal taste. It's ridiculous. It is unbelievable. And it carries on. It needs to stop. And, you know, you don't go out and beat someone senseless because they like a different movie to you. I mean, you don't go out and beat someone up because they like Avengers over Suicide Squad. I mean, it's a logical choice, but that's not the point. You know, you don't go out and beat someone because they like How I Met Your Mother instead of Friends, you know. So why would you go outside because they, you know, go out and beat someone up because they like Deicide instead of Taylor Swift? You know, it makes no sense. You know, music is music. Music is one of these fundamental things that brings people together. You know, it's something that everybody in the world, I don't think there's a single person in the world who doesn't like some kind of music. So why has it become this thing where people who listen to alternative music have become a target for attack just because of the style of music they listen to? I mean, you don't see people getting attacked because they listen to Neil Diamond. You don't see people getting attacked because they listen to, like, classical music or opera or country music. It only ever seems to be these people that listen to alternative music that are getting attacked. And it is ridiculous that it's happening. And why? What is the excuse? What is the reason that this specific demographic of people are getting attacked? There is no need for it. And like I said, these people are getting violently attacked. They are getting seriously hurt. And it's come to the point where a young woman was killed. She was beaten so severely that she died from her injuries just because of the clothes she was wearing and the music she listened to. You know, her and her boyfriend were set upon by a group of people and violently beaten. The boyfriend thankfully survived. But the young woman, Sophie Lancaster, died because she was beaten so severely. These people didn't know her. They didn't know her or her boyfriend. They had no idea who they were. Never spoken to them. But just because they didn't like the way she looked or, you know, the music that she listened to, they thought it was an acceptable thing to attack them. And that is the farthest thing from truth. It's unacceptable. No one should have to lose their life because they like a different style of music. It's disgusting that this sort of thing happens. And this is what Sophie Lancaster Foundation wants to put an end to. They don't want to see anybody else go through this. They don't want to see another family have to go through what they went through. You know, they don't want another person to lose their life because they like a different style of music. You know, everybody has the right to be an individual. Nobody has the right to tell you otherwise. And I thoroughly believe this. I thoroughly support this. You know, there are styles of music I don't like, but I don't berate people for it. I don't attack people or insult people because they like different music to me. You know, if I don't like it, I won't listen to it. It's really simple. So, you know, this needs more attention brought to it. Something needs to be done. This needs to stop. So if you'd like to find out more about the Sophie Lancaster Foundation, there is a link to their website in the description below. You can pop over there, find out what they're working on at the moment, find out what their goal is, because they can explain it a whole lot better than I can. And if you can help them in any way, even something as simple as one of these bracelets, they're like £1 on the web store, I think. They have a ton of other merchandise on there as well. Every little bit helps. The smallest amount can make the biggest difference. And the sooner we can bring more attention to this, the sooner we can stamp out prejudice, hatred, and intolerance everywhere. But I'm going to leave that as it is for the time being. Thank you all very, very much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.